Hi, my name is Pablo Requena and I am a guitar maker. I make classical and flamenco guitars, but I also run guitar making courses, and some of my students that come to my courses to build a one-off instrument. It's a great experience, but that's as much as they do. They just build one and go home and take home a really great guitar that they made themselves. But there's also many of my students that they come to me to actually learn how to become luthiers themselves, and they want to build more instruments. And so this video really, it's for them, because this is really a reminder of how you assemble the guitar. And once you have built all the components to a certain degree, to a certain level of finish, then you need to bring them all together in this mold. Now, this mold is what you call a Solera mold. And it's called a Solera mold, really, because it comes apart like this. And this is what you would call the Solera. And there are many ways of doing this element, this Solera. And the way that I've done it is really by raising this face with a little bit of cork, so that by the time I put my soundboard here, it's going to allow for the belly of the soundboard to not to be squashed and to be free, so that it doesn't touch this area. But everything else is well supported. Now, another important element of this Solera is that the 12th fret point, which is at this line, it slopes down very gradually from this face. So if I was going to put a straight edge all along here, I would see that it's resting in here, it's resting at that 12th fret point, but at this stage, at this point, it will have about 1.5 millimeter clearance. So there's a very slight slope here, and that's important because when the guitar comes out of mold, we need to have that very slight angle forward of the neck for the whole setup to be able to work out properly. So we're gonna see how to assemble all the elements in this mold. So the first thing that we do is to fit in the soundboard. The soundboard, a very important thing to bear in mind is that we want to have the center line running along the center line of my mold, which it runs along here and all the way up there, all the way along. And that center line also will follow the position of the neck. So for now, what I'm going to do is that the center line needs to line up with this one here and also up here. And then also I have drawn the perimeter of the guitar, which you can see this line here, and this line is going to line up with this one. So basically I'm just going to bring the top up just to meet this line, so this line will be the continuation of the one in the jig, and then it will line up this center line with the line in the Solera. And then down here it's exactly the same, so it's a little bit off there. So I'm just going to move it very slightly just to get it in the right place, like that. So once I'm happy with that, all I need to do is to fix it in place. So I have a bolt that I fit in from underneath and bring it all the way through. And then I've got this little bit of rosewood with a bit of tape so that it doesn't dent any of my bars. I'm just going to put it here. I'm going to put a washer, and then I'm going to put this wing nut here. And before I tighten it up, I'm just going to do another check to make sure that nothing moved, and I'm happy with that. I think this is good. So now I can tighten it, and I can tighten it quite firmly and nothing is going to break, because this bar is well supported, but this one, which is arched, you can see it's supported with a bit of cork right at the point where this block would be pushing. So it's everything is well supported and good and steady, so I can clamp this, and now this is not going to move, and it's in the right place. Now you can see that these two bars, these are called the harmonic bars, they are a little bit too long. So we need to decide where we're going to be cutting them, and to allow for the two sides of the mold to be able to go in. You can see that that's too long. I've got these two lines there, but actually I would like to clean them up and then you can see how they've been marked. So all I need to do is to get this part of the mold, put it in place like that. This mold, maybe I'll show you, it's got these dowels, and what that means is that the mold will always come to the same place. That's if I can find a hole. There you are. So now I could just mark it here, but actually I want the bar to be slightly shorter because I want the sides to be able to fit in there. So what I'm going to do is to get a little bit of an offcut, which is the same thickness as my side, and I'm going to put it in here, and that's where I'm going to make my pencil line, and then the same in this bar. And you can see that now that will be the lines that I need to be followed to cut. I'm going to do the same with the other side. And then again, I put this one here and mark it up like that, and this one there and mark it up. So let's cut them off. Now, to do this job, it's really not too complicated. All we have to do is, with my Japanese saw, I can use my thumb as a resting point for the saw, and then I'm just going to cut right next to that line. Now, one thing that I like doing is that I want to cut all the way down, and even to the point in which I scratch my soundboard a little bit. And I like doing that because that way I know that the bar is being cut completely, and all I need to do is just hold it in place, and with the back of the saw I can just knock it off and it will come off without me having to go around with a chisel cleaning it up and everything. If I didn't cut all the way through, I wouldn't be able to do that. And the reason why I don't mind cutting into here is because actually that area of the soundboard is all going to be coming off later on when I put the bindings. So I'm not too worried about cutting a little bit into that area there. Now I'm going to do the same in here. Again, I'm going to scratch it off so that then I hold it and knock it. In here I have a little bit stuck in there, so I can just lift it up with my finger, and actually I'm going to do a little bit of cleaning. I'm just going to get this chisel and I'm just going to clean this up like that. Now I'm going to do this one. Now here I need to be a little bit more careful because I don't want to be scratching anything where I can see. So I'm going to be much more careful. Like that. Now all I need to do is with my chisel, knock it, and I don't have to clean anything. And now I'm going to do the other side, but actually I'm going to do it from here. There. Okay, so again, I can now go in with my chisel. And yeah, a little bit of cleaning, but hardly anything really, like that. Right, I'm going to put this chisel back before I damage it. Right, so now I should be able to put in these parts of the mold, and that one fits in there very nicely, and then this one here. Right, before I go on, basically the next job would be, from here I can screw the sides in, But before I do that, I want to see how the neck will come into here. So I just want to check that this will come in the right place. So I'm just checking that this is lining up in the center. This is lining up in the center. And I just get an old offcut, bring it here. And this one might break actually. Yeah, it did break. Right, I will do it with a smaller piece. But yes, I'm happy with that. I think this will come in absolutely well. Yeah, that's good. Right, so I can check that I've got enough gap for the sides. That's big enough. And that one, I don't know about that one. Let me check with this. Yeah, it'll be fine. That one is fine, fine, and fine. Right, so now I can put in these bolts. Too big. I think there must be a smaller one on here. Yeah. I like starting them by hand. This one I wasn't sure what was doing. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna put this one in. There's something wrong there. But all the other ones, if I start it by hand, then I know they're going with the thread in the right way. That one also needs a bit of encouragement. Yep. Yes, I'm gonna have to sort this one out later. That's fine. That one. And that one. So now I've got my drill with an hexagonal bit. Okay. These two, I'm gonna try to put them in and see if they're gonna go in well, and if not, I can do that. They don't really need it, but yeah, that's fine. Okay. So you can see the first element it's in, which is the soundboard. Now the next thing to bring in, it would be the neck. And the neck needs to have a little recess here so that this part of the neck is flush with the front of the soundboard. So the step, or the amount that we need to remove here, is exactly the same thickness at the soundboard at this point. So I will be putting a little bit of glue here, and then I will make sure that my center line lines up with the center of that little black square, which is actually a spline going up the neck. So that will go in the middle there, if I can see, like that. And then up this end, it will need to go also in the middle. I have this line there, which needs to line up with that one, like that. Okay, so before I glue it, I want to do a little bit of work on the sides, because if I glue this on now, which I could do, then things are going to be a little bit more awkward later on. So I have my sides ready here, and they have been bent in my bending jig, and they just go in. They don't need any sort of adjustments or anything like it, so they go straight in. So all I'm going to do is to hold them in place with a couple of clamps, so I can use this one here like that, make sure that the waist fits in properly, then I can put another clamp there like that. This side fits in really well. And now what I need to do is to mark where the side meets the center line. Okay? So what I'll do is to use a ruler, and I'm not gonna draw the whole line, I'm just gonna make a little mark at the bottom. I got this is well pressed in, I got the ruler in place there. And I'm just going to put a little mark here, like that. So the ruler is just helping me to locate the pencil. And now I'm going to come and do this one over here. So I press in all the way, bring that one there. Like that. So now I can take it out. And I'm going to do the same with the other one. So again, this side fits in really well. So, one clamp. Go and do another mark here as well, so you make sure that the side is all fitted well, and I bring the ruler right next to the center line, and I make a little mark there. and then I'm going to do the same up here. Okay, okay. So now I can take these two clamps off. I can take the side out. And now I can get the mold out of the way so that we can do a little bit of work on the sides. So these are the lines that I need to mark. So with my square and with this pen, I'm going to bring it over. I'm using the square only on this side, which is a straight side. So I bring it over there and mark it all up. Like that, and then in this side I need to have the square in this other side, so I bring it here like this, the same in the other one. Okay. Now, if I was to cut, this line didn't back very well. I'll do it again. So if I was to cut that line and along this line, and the same, this one goes like that, and the same here, you would see that actually everything will follow the shape of the guitar and the sides will meet very well down here at the end. But in this area where the neck goes, we need to create enough room for this heel block to go in. So we actually, this line represents the center line in this block. Imagine there's a center line here, but that line would be that one. So if we cut it there, actually it wouldn't work. So we need to work out where do we actually have to cut it. Okay, so that's what we're going to do now. And what we need to know is that when we build the neck, the dimensions that we have for the marking out of all these slots and cuts, it's 5 millimeters down here and 15 millimeters there. So let's check that again. So from the center line to here, you've got 5 millimeters and 5 millimeters there, and then again from the center to here you have 15 millimeters and a little bit more than that one, actually 16 or 15 and a half. So we'll take that and bear the better in mind. So if this is going to be cut like this, it means that our cut needs to be in this direction. So in this side we are going to mark 15 millimeters here and 5 millimeters up here. And then we're going to join this line and that is the real line to follow. Let's do the same in the other one. So here you can see that that needed to be in this size. So in this side we got 15. And in this side we have 5. So I'm going to mark 5 millimeters here, like that. And then we just need to mark it out. That didn't go very well, so let's do it again. Yeah, that's better. Right, so before we do any cutting, it's good to check that we've got everything marked in the right way. So if I put the sides like that, I can see that both cuts will go to become thin at this end, which is that area there, a bit wider at the bottom, which is what we need here, a bit wider at the bottom, and this is all fine. So we can now go and cut them. So to cut this up, we are going to use this Japanese saw. And I'm also going to use a block here to help me with that job. So I'm going to put this in there. Okay, and then the other side. Let's do the other one. That didn't break off there. And now this one. So now I'm going to bring my mould back. And this side will come in here. this one into there. And you can see that that area that we've got left there is the same as the area that we have in this block. So that will work out just right. Now, the next job to do, before we start gluing things together, is we have these wedges, and these wedges will fit into here nice and tight, so they need to go in a certain way. So that's why I put those markings there, because if I by mistake put them in the right in the wrong way, they just wouldn't fit in. Actually, it looks like it would work, but yeah, not really. It's got a gap there, so it's not the right thing. So they're a little bit longer than they need to be. That's the one for this side. So what I do is to bring the side in place like that, then put in the right wedge in place and push the weight tight. Check that the wedge goes in and check that this gap, well, there's no gap actually. This joint has no gaps or anything. That looks really good. So I'm just gonna press a little bit. And now I want to cut off everything that is sticking out over here. So, sorry, I'm gonna put it in this way. On the other side over here. So what I'm going to do is resting the saw in this face, and I'm not going to cut it all the way through. I'm going to leave a little bit there. And then I'm going to finish cutting it in the bench. So this wedge now is exactly the right length, so that when we bring it into here, we know that this is going to stop flush with that. So let's do the other one. So we put in this side into here, there like that. Now we bring the other wedge, put it in place, press it in a little bit, check that there is no gaps. Yeah, and that's also a nice join. I'm happy with that. So let's bring it here, but this time I'm going to do it this way. And again, I don't want to cut all the way through, because I don't want to be cutting into the neck actually. So I've just got it just where it needs to be, and I'm just going to knock it out like that, and then I can cut it by hand on the bench, and that's it. So now I know that when this one goes in, it will, this end of the wedge will be flush with this area here. If it wasn't, what it means is that it could push in into the soundboard as we drive them in. You'll see that a bit later. Right, so now we would be ready to assemble everything. So we had the soundboard is in the right place now. So the next thing to put in place is the neck. I'm not going to glue anything at the moment. I'm just going to do a dry run, but what I will be doing is put a little bit of glue here, and I don't know if you noticed, there's a little bit of tape underneath in the mould, and that's so that the squeeze out doesn't come and stick the guitar and the mould together. Okay, so that will protect the glue. So I bring this into here. This edge needs to touch this edge, so I bring it there, and then pong all the way up, and then here this line must line up with the center of the black square. and then up here the same. The center line, which is up here, needs to line up with the center of the neck. Once I've got it like that, and remember there is glue in there already, or there would be, so what I do is that I get a clamp, I put a block in here, and I clamp the neck into there, not too much pressure, and then I can clamp this area here with this little device. It's basically no more than a strip of cedar with a couple of bolts in place, and doing it like that, it means that I can carry on working without having a clamp underneath, which is going to be interfering. So I'm just going to drive it in. Sorry. This now is fixed in place. This is fixed in place, so you must remember that this clamp is the last one to be removed when you're taking the guitar out of the mold. Remember, if you take this clamp out, this area is very vulnerable and you could break something. So now we are ready to bring in the sides. This one is the one for here, and this one is the one there. But before I put them in, I also need to have a bit of paper. I'll be back in a second. I just want... So I just got a little bit of paper that I don't need. So I can cut a strip like that. And on one side, in this one for example, I can do it a bit smaller. I can put a little bit of paper held with a bit of tape, and now what I do is to fit in this side first into here like that. And then I fit in this side. And the reason why I want to have this paper here, it's also because the glue that will be when we glue this block in, I don't want it to go through and get it stuck to the mold. Now what I've done is that I've fitted in the end first so that the length is right here and these two sides are coming together. And then up here in the heel, that's where I will be bringing it slowly and gradually in, so that is already in, and now this is all in the right place. So this fits in really well. Now sometimes, if you need it, this guitar actually doesn't really need it. It fits like a glove. But if there were any gaps here, you can make yourself a block similar to this, and basically all this is a couple of blocks which this curve will fit there. Actually have an arrow here, so it means this one goes here, so this shape fits into here very nicely. So all you need to do is to put this into here, put it there, and then I have this and knob here, so make sure that everything fits in the right way, and then you can push everything in place. We're gonna leave it there for now, but you know, we didn't really need it on this one because it fits really well. So now we will be able to fit in the wedges. Make sure that we put in the right way, the right wedge in the right slot,
And you don't need to have any glue in this side. You put the glue in this side, that one and that one, the three sides that I encountered here. And you will be gluing it, making sure that it goes flush all the way in, and then bring it all the way down. And usually if you just try by hand, it won't be enough. You actually have to drive it in with the hammer. And the way, or how do you know that it's driven all the way through? Well, what I do is that I put glue in this end, and then as I'm driving it in, as soon as I see a little bit of glue squeezing out, then I know I need to stop. That way I know that I'm not going to be driving it through too far into the soundboard. And then I'm going to fit this one in, which goes in this way, like that. So this end is now done. Remember, I'm doing everything without glue so that I can do it later on a little bit slowly and without having to rush too much. But basically, it's exactly the same process. So now I have my end block in here and I've got it ready. This end block has an arch in this face, which is very subtle, and it's exactly the same arch that I have at the end here. I'm going to cut this off so that we can see things a bit better. And then this is just another arch here. You can use whatever shape you want. This is just really to debulk this a little bit. And I like have this chamfer here so that this is the only area that is in touch with the soundboard, which is actually also the same area as the size of the tentaglions that I'm using. You got one here. So you can see that this area, it's, or that width is the same as that. So you don't need to make a great big block here. And so I will be putting glue in this face and in this face at the bottom. I bring it in place, and the way to clamp it is right. So I have this little block, which it happens to have the same curve as my block here. And then I have this other block, and basically it's no more than a piece of plywood with lots of cuts, and the cuts don't go all the way through. You got there about 2 millimeters, and it will make it flexible. And then I have sellotape in this side so that the glue doesn't stick together. So this will actually take this shape. So what I do, like I say, put your glue here and there, bring it into the middle. Try to make sure that it goes in the middle of the guitar, and then with a clamp like this or any other clamp that you might find in your workshop, bring this all the way down, and I'm going to put this into here already, and then you can squeeze that nice and tight. Make sure that this block doesn't slide up when you're gluing it, because the glue will want to make things a bit slippery and it could come up. So to stop it from coming up, I think I have another block here. Yes, this one. So this block will go there, and what that will do is that I can now put a clamp in here to push my block down. Okay. Now I have these two little areas that they need to be supported. So that's why I have this block in here. I don't know if you can see it from this side better. This block inside I will use to clamp into here and into there. So that's what I'm going to do now. I'm just going to get one clamp in this side. Like that. And another clamp in the other side. Like this. Actually, I'm going to bring this one down a bit. Like that. So, once you are at that stage, it's time to glue in all the tentillones or peones, depends where you are, they're called in different ways. I've got them up here in my box. And basically, they're no more than little brackets that have been cut, and I have made them out of a Spanish cedar, Cedrela odorata, and basically you have 90 degrees in this face, and basically whatever angles that's worked out, it doesn't really matter. What you might want to know is that the width of this block is 8 millimeters, the length along this side it's 9, and the length along this other side it's 20. Okay, so this, we got loads of them, you can see this will do maybe 6 or 7 guitars. And what you're gonna do is sort yourself out with a little bit of glue in a little pot with a little brush, and you're gonna pin them in with a bradawl like that, put a little bit of glue in each side, and then bring them in place. And what you need to do is to glue them all the way along the perimeter inside the guitar. So these ones will go all the way along here. Actually, this one is a bit bigger, so I would use it for something else. And I like gluing them one right next to the other one. Some people choose to leave a gap in between them. That's really up to you, but I think for me it works better when the peones are together. With gaps like that, you can end up having runs of glue coming all the way down when you glue in your bindings. So doing it like this, you avoid all of that, and the guitar looks a bit neat inside. It looks neater and more tidy. So basically, you're going to need to put all these peones all the way along here, all the way along this center section, and all the way along the bottom bow, and the same in the other side. On top of the harmonic bars, again, you could use one of these. That would probably be fine, but I like using a bigger bracket, which comes up to the bottom of the lining that we'll put here. The one in the lower harmonic bar, it comes up 40 millimeters. It's just my preference. If you use a small peon like this, it would be fine as well, but I always feel that it's nicer to do it that way. Right, so now all that's left to do is to fit the back. So I'm gonna get So this is one of the linings that I've got ready, and I need to do a bit of work on it. I need to basically round one of the edges. So when this is all glued and dry, and I take all of this off, and I take all of, you know, I cut off the excess here as well, I've already got the right shape here, so I will be able to just glue my linings in place inside here. I have an offcut over here, so I may be able to show you with the offcut. I think it was here, yeah, there it is. So you can see in this offcut that you have one round edge, and that will come into here. And when I glue it, I want to make sure that it's not flush, and of course not lower than the rosewood. It needs to be about 1 millimeter higher than the rosewood, and that is because later on I will be using a mold to be able to get the final shape into here so that I can receive the back. Now, that fitting the back is another job altogether in its own right, so that will be the subject for another video. For now, I think you got the gist of what it's involved in putting the guitar together, and it will remind you all the basic steps that we've been doing in the courses when we did them together. So if you have any questions or you're not sure, please just send me an email and I can, you know, remind you or explain a little bit further something that you think that is not clear enough. And like I said before at the beginning of the video, I do guitar making courses in which you can come along and you can build all of this together with me, and you will end up with a fantastic guitar to take home with you that you have built from scratch all the way. So
Also, if you like this video, press like and subscribe to my channel so that you can be receiving all the videos that I put in, all related to making guitars. So thank you for watching the video, and until the next one.